Hey everybody, welcome back to HD Piano. This is Jeff. In today's lesson, we're going to take you back to 1984, and I'm going to teach you how to play Take On Me by A-ha. And we're going to be learning the main riff, which is the part that you definitely need to know. That's going to sound something like this. And there you have it. All right, let's start with right hand by itself. So the first move of this synth melody outlines a B minor triad, and we're one octave above middle C. So here's middle C, here's one octave above it, and we're gonna start with two F sharps, and then a D and a B. And after that, we're gonna play one B, and three E's. So F sharp, D, B, another B, and then three E's. And our rhythm, I'll play nice and slow. Okay, so listen one more time with my snapping. And you're gonna notice that most of the notes in this synth line are on what we call upbeats. So my snap is the downbeats, one, two, three, and four. And the parts of the melody happen on the upbeat, or the ands. So I would pause, rewind once you get that part, and then meet me back here for the rest of the first phrase, which is two G sharps. A, B. Okay, and so that in its entirety we're going to call phrase one. Okay, let me try it a little slower. Okay, so same thing. Take a few minutes, pause, rewind, learn that first phrase, phrase one, really well, and then meet me back here. Now we're going to add the left hand to phrase one. So our two chords are B minor. This one's in root position, B, D, F sharp, and E major. This is in second inversion, B, E, G sharp. B minor, E major. And check out where these chords come in with phrase one. So actually, these chords are just being held as whole notes. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So the chords in this synth line may ground you in your downbeats. The E chord sneaks in between the first two E's. Okay, so try that a few times, nice and slow. All right, work on that for a bit. Meet me back here for phrase two. And here's what phrase two is going to sound like. Okay, let's do the right hand first. We start with three A's, and then we go down to an E. Then D, and then three F sharps. Okay, so A, E, D, three F sharps. And that rhythm. Same rhythm as before. And then the last four notes of the phrase are going to be E, E, F sharp, E. And when we put it together, do it even slower. Very good. So same thing. Pause, rewind, practice that second phrase, right hand only, nice and slow. And when you're ready, we can add the left hand. So this part has three chords, this second phrase. It's got an A chord in root position, A, C sharp, E. And then we're going to jump up to a D chord, also in root position, D, F sharp, A. And then we're going to step down to a C sharp minor chord, C sharp, E, G sharp. So those chords, A, D, C sharp minor. And the rhythm of these chords, we're going to have whole note A, 1, 2, 3, 4, half note, half note. 2, 3, 4, half note, half note. It could be more helpful to know where these chords land in relation to the melody, though. So here's how it happens. I'll play it nice and slow. So the D chord happens in between the first two F sharps. And the C sharp minor chord happens right when you play that part of the phrase. Okay, I'll play the whole thing hands together slowly. Maybe a little faster. Okay, let's try our first two phrases together. 3, 4. Sorry, let's take that one more time. 3, 4. All right, well done. You may have noticed that I put an inversion on that D chord. That's totally fine. If that's what you're more comfortable with, you can do an inversion. You could also go up to root position. I think both sound fine here. Let's try it one more time, nice and slow. Okay, well done. So that whole four measure phrase, we had sort of the first part and the second part, repeats. Okay, so we're going to play that two times through what we just learned, and then we're going to get to the end of the phrase, which sounds like this. Okay, so it's a little change. We start the same way. Okay, we've seen that before, and this section is new. Okay, a little bit different. And here's what's going on here. Let's do the right hand. Right hand starts with three A's, same as before. But instead of going down to E, we go down to F sharp. Then we go to D, and then three F sharps. Okay, let's try that. I'll play that with a snapping. So you can hear all those F sharps are on the upbeat. And then we finish the phrase with three E's, three and four. And let's add left hand to that when you're ready. It'll be a B minor triad, B, D, F sharp, and an E major triad, B, E, G sharp. And this E chord is going to sneak in between the first two F sharps. I'll play it nice and slow, hands together. pause, rewind, make sure you get it at that slow tempo. Let's try it a little faster. Okay, how's everybody feeling? Let's review. All right, so let's do the first phrase, the whole four-measure phrase, which we're going to repeat two times. And let's play this still at a pretty slow tempo. Repeat. Now the variation. Very good. Let's try it one more time, closer to the speed of the record. One, two, three, four. Excellent work, everyone. You now know the classic synth riff to Take On Me by A-ha. You can click on the link above to watch part two and start your free trial over at hdpiano.com. You can hit the subscribe button to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook and send out those requests for songs via Twitter. Thanks so much for watching HD Piano. I'm Jeff, and I'll see you at the next lesson.